Hey guys, what's up? I'm Mark, and in this channel, I talk a bit about lifestyle and I talk a lot about personal finance and investments. In this video, we're gonna be talking about one of the things that you guys really like to invest in, and I know this subject makes a lot of you excited. We are going to talk about IPOs. Now, 2022 is shaping up to be a very exciting year in the Philippine stock market in terms of IPOs. There is said to be 10 companies planning to go public, so more IPOs for you guys to invest in. But before looking forward to those IPOs, I wanted to step back to last year's IPOs. Have the IPOs in the Philippine stock market in 2021 actually work out as great investments? Are our local IPOs really worth the hype? Join me today as we check on this. Let's go. So what I'm gonna be looking at are the 8 IPOs last year. I'm gonna be checking on their IPO price, and I'm gonna be comparing it to today's current price. So this is being filmed on the morning of January 11th. So the prices and the performance may have already changed by the time I release this video. Let's start with the best performing ones. The best performing one would be the most recent debut. And this is Solar Philippines Nueva Ecija Corporation, which had its offer price at 1 peso and is currently trading at 1 peso and 32 centavos. Solar Philippines has gains of over 30%. Following this would be the Robinson's Land Commercial REIT. RCR's offer price was at 6 pesos and 45 centavos and it's currently trading at 8 pesos and 19 centavos with a gain of nearly 27%. And this trading price is actually its highest since its debut. Third on the list would be the Mega World REIT or MREIT. MREIT's offer price was at 16 pesos and 10 centavos. It's currently trading at 19 pesos and 48 centavos with a gain of nearly 21%. Its peak was actually at 19 pesos and 70 centavos, so it's still trading near the highest levels right now. Following this would be those in the middle of the pack. Mond Nissen Corporation IPO'd at 13 pesos and 50 centavos. Its current price is at 15 pesos and 90 centavos with a current gain of nearly 18%. Following this would be the last among those still in the positive. This would be the Philinvest Land REIT. Its IPO price was at 7 pesos and it's currently trading at 7 pesos and 69 centavos. So its gains are actually less than 10%. So those 5 actually comprise those IPOs that actually worked out. Now we move on to the more interesting part. So there are 3 that are actually in the red that when comparing the current price to its IPO price is actually even much lower. So let's start off with Alday Supermarkets. Alday's IPO price started at 60 centavos and it's currently trading 59 centavos. So this is pretty much flat. Maybe we don't have to call it a negative, we can just call it breaking even if you guys want to consider that a non-loss. At its best, however, Alday peaked at 90 centavos, but this was only very briefly, I think within the first or second day of the trading before plunging back, basically trading within the IPO price. The second on our list of laggards would be Double Dragon Meridian Park or DDMP. Of course, DDMP is famously owned as a joint venture between Tony Tan-Caktiong of Jollibee and Injap of Mang Inasal. So DDMP's IPO price was at 2 pesos and 25 centavos and it's currently trading at 1 peso and 79 centavos, meaning that currently, this stock is down over 20% since its IPO. Last on this list would be the infamous Medilines IPO. So the IPO price for Medic was at 2 pesos and 30 centavos. It's currently trading at 1 peso and 12 centavos. So currently, this stock is down over 51% since its IPO debut. Its best trading price was at 1 peso and 70 centavos, which meant that it was down by over 26% at its best. So to recap, out of the 8 IPOs last year, 3 of them are actually trading below the IPO price, leaving 5 of them, of course, in the positive. So if you're the type of person who likes to get into all of these IPOs, you have a 62% chance of your bet actually working out for you. So that's 5 out of the 8 IPOs. On the corollary, you have a chance of more than 35% for your money to be trading below its IPO price. So definitely, in as much as there's so much excitement that surrounds an IPO, there's a lot of fanfare when companies go public, we really have to check each IPO and not treat them all evenly. All IPOs are not created equal. So we really have to do our homework and check and see what are the prospects of the company and the stock and will it really perform? There are actually three things that I've abstracted from this data. And just as a disclaimer, I'm not a financial investment professional. I'm just really an amateur investor. So these opinions will be completely my own. These are just my observations. These are the things that I've come to conclude based on this bird's eye view of this data. The first would be REIT IPOs aren't exactly a sure thing. Now, in as much as REITs have been the hot investment ticket in the past year, with the Ayala Land REIT debuting and performing so well, it's encouraged a lot of developers and real estate companies to maximize this financial instrument and come up with their own REITs. In as much as REITs are very exciting, they promise good dividends, the performance of their stocks have not been a catch-all or a guarantee that all REITs are actually giving great returns. So looking at 2022, there are actually a handful of REITs that are in the pipeline. So there's Citicor, there's SMPH, there's Vista Land, and there's another Double Dragon Jollibee Group REIT that's coming up. So with these REITs coming up, again, do a bit of your homework. I'm also going to try to look into those REITs once they are within the offer period or when. So the number two thing that I noticed about last year's IPOs, and this might be a little controversial, the IPOs that have been underwhelming would have been the All Day Supermarket, again, the Double Dragon Meridian Park REIT, and Medilines. These companies are owned by the same companies that actually have had a number of IPOs in the last 2 to 3 years. So famously, DDMP also had its affiliate Mary Mart do an IPO in 2020, while on the other hand, All Day Supermarket had its affiliate company All Home also do a debut in 2020. And of course, All Day is somewhat related to the Medilines IPO. They're not exactly related, but as you know, the owners are brothers, so somewhat these companies are related. So what this data is showing is that those who are frequenting the IPO as a means to raise funds haven't exactly had great performing stocks. So this is just something for you to keep in mind, to watch out for. If you see a company going public, also check how much have their recent IPOs performed. Historical data would be there to help guide us through. Lastly, I just have to single out Solar Philippines as the best performer from last year's IPOs. It took me by surprise that the public actually received it well, since Solar Philippines actually applied for a special listing. Companies operating within the renewable energy industry can actually list even as a company would be pre-revenue. And since there are IPOs this year that will be focusing on renewable energy, maybe that's something that we have to keep our eye on. The first would be the Citicor REIT, and the second would be Pavi Green, which is also owned within the Villar Group. So with the surprising performance of Solar Philippines, I think we can actually look at the renewable energy sector as something that might have profitable returns in the near future. So what do you think, guys? Are IPOs actually worth the hype? Which IPOs this year are you excited about? I hope this brief summary of last year's IPOs give you some perspective on how the stocks have performed and if it's something that you would like to invest in or not. I hope this has been helpful. If you've liked this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thanks again and happy investing.